Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, beta. So what we were doing, you have a function of two variables, and we were doing how to find out the minima or maxima. Suppose the first test is that you have to find out, we say that minima or maxima, local maxima or minima occurs at critical points or boundary points. Now, what are critical points? These are the points where fx is 0 and fy is 0. And what are critical points? Are either the points where fx and fy both are 0, or where fx or fy or both don't exist. Okay, so these are the three possible places where you look for minima and maxima. Okay, and out of for global maxima minima, for global maxima minima, what you will do, calculate the value of the function, on all the local maxima minima, and then find out which one is global. Okay, so this is how you find out the global maxima minima. And also we had a test that also we have this thing that a critical point may not always be the point of maxima and minima. We call such points as saddle points, where fx and fy both are 0, but it is neither the point of minima nor the point of maxima. And we have this test, which is called second derivative test for local maxima minima. We have already discussed it, but I'm writing it here. Second derivative test for local maxima minima. What is this test? That suppose at a point A comma B, both fx A comma B is 0 and fy A comma B is 0, right? Suppose at a point A comma B, both fx is 0 and fy is 0, then at this point you will compute fxx minus fy, fxx means second derivative with respect to x into fyy minus fxy square. Okay, if this is positive, if this quantity is positive, then you will look at fxx. If fxx is negative, then point of maxima. And if fxx is positive, then point of minima, local maxima, local minima. And if this quantity is negative, then it is a saddle point. And if this quantity is 0, then test fails. Is that okay? So this is the recap of what we had done in the last lecture. So now I will, today's class, I will discuss some problems. And also note that till now,
ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, it's f x y whole square.
Sorry?
The equation is f x x into f x f y y minus yes. f x y whole square.
No, only f x y square.
Yes, okay.
Okay, so it is this determinant. F x x, f x y, f x y, f y y. So this will be this into this minus this into this. That is f x y square. Fine?
Okay, ma'am.
So, till now, also note that we have not discussed problems where boundary is given. Okay, so all the problems which we have already done, there was no boundary given. So in today's class, the problems we'll discuss.
Ma'am?
Yes.
मैम बट इट इज रिटर्न एट एफ वाई वाई में जो आपने किया ना वो लेस देन जीरो लिखा है
सैडल पॉइंट. सैडल पॉइंट मींस इट्स काइंड ऑफ पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन. इट इज द पॉइंट वेयर यू थिंक दैट मिनिमम मैक्सिमम विल अकर बट दिस इज नॉट नीदर द पॉइंट ऑफ मिनिमम नॉर द पॉइंट ऑफ मैक्सिमम. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड an example also where fx and fy both were zero but that was neither the point of minima nor the point of maxima. Okay, so that is the saddle point. Saddle point which yeah. you use as inflection point. Okay beta, so let me do problems. So this is the first problem. Find the absolute means global. Okay, absolute maxima and minima. This is global of fxy is equal to 2 plus 2x plus 2y minus x square minus y square on a triangular plate in the first quadrant bounded by the lines x is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, and y is equal to 9 minus x. Okay, so let me tell you what is the statement. Statement is you are given a function 2 plus 2x plus 2y minus x square minus y square, and you are given a region also where you have to look for maxima minima. So what is the region? Region is a triangular plate in the first quadrant bounded by the lines x is equal to 0. So what is the line x is equal to 0? That is your y-axis. So this is the line x is equal to 0. And this is the line y is equal to 0. And then there is a line y is equal to 9 minus x. How you will plot this line? This is x plus y is equal to 9. So this is x upon 9 plus y upon 9 is equal to 1. So you know this is the intercept form. X upon x intercept plus y upon y intercept is equal to 1. So this is a line whose x-intercept is 9 and y-intercept is also 9. So this is the line. Is that okay? So this is the plate we are talking about. So it means that you are asked to find out the minima and maxima of this function in this region. Is the question clear to everybody? So this line is x is equal to 0. This line is y is equal to 0. And this line here is y is equal to 9 minus x. So you look at the statement that find the absolute minima and maxima of this function on a triangular plate in the first quadrant, which is bounded by these three lines. X is equal to 0, y is equal to 0, y is equal to 9 minus x. Clear, beta? Okay. Any doubt in the statement?
No, ma'am.
Yes?
No, ma'am.
So now we know that minima maxima, you see, you are asked to find out the global minima maxima. But before that, you will find out your local minima maxima. And out of all those local values, we will find out the one which is having the maximum value. That will be your global maxima. And we will find out the one which is having the minimum value. That will be your global minima. And we know that maxima minima, local maxima minima will occur at critical points or boundary points. So now what are critical points? Let us look at what are critical points. Critical points are the points where derivatives does not exist. Fx or fy or fx or both don't exist. So do you think for this function there is a point where fx or fy or f or both don't exist? Can you tell me? Yes, no? For this function here, can you tell me a point where fx or fy or both don't exist?
It is a polynomial function.
This is a polynomial function, a nice function, differentiable everywhere. So there is no such point where fx or fy or fx or both don't exist, right? So the second kind of points, which are called critical points, are where fx is 0 and fy is 0. So now fx is 0 means, find out what is fx. Fx means 2 minus 2x is 0, so x is 1. And fy is 0, that tells you 2 minus 2y is 0, that is y is equal to 1. So it means that the critical point is 1, 1. Okay, so this is the critical point. You have to make sure that this point lies in the region. This point lies in the given region. In the given region. So do you think this point lies in the region? This is the region. Yes, 1, 1 will be somewhere here. So we got that this is the critical point, and you can find out the value of the function at this point. 1, 1, that will be 2 plus 2 into 1 plus 2 into 1 minus 1 minus 1, that is 4. Is that okay, beta? Clear to everybody? So this is the only critical point which I have got. Now let us look for the boundary points. So let us look for the boundary points. So your boundary points are, can you tell me what is the boundary here?
0, 0, 9, 0, and 0, 9.
You see, this is the boundary, this is the boundary, and this is like, these three lines are the boundaries. So what we do, you just name these points, say you call it O, this is origin, A, B. Now boundary is along OA. First of all, you take OA or whatever line you want. So along OA, you have y is equal to 0. Along OA, y is 0. Therefore, fxy becomes fx0, that is equal to 2 plus 2x plus 2 into 0 minus x square minus 0 square. So this is 2 plus 2x minus x square. So along this boundary, your function will be a function of one variable. Okay, so you have to find out maxima minima of this function on the interval 0 to 9. On the interval 0 to 9. Is that thing clear? So we have to find out maxima minima of this function on interval 0 to 9. Clear, beta? This is for the boundary OA, for this boundary here. Fine. Now, you already know that for function of one variable, how to find out the maxima minima? Maxima minima will be either at the boundary. Boundary means at the point 0 or at the point 9 or at a point where its derivative with respect to x is 0. So, what you will say that maxima minima will occur at x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 9 or the points where dy by dx of 2 plus 2x minus x square is 0. So it will occur at dy by dx of this quantity 0 means 2 minus 2x is equal to 0. That is, you get x is equal to 1. So therefore, your points are x0, x9 and x1 and everywhere y is 0. So therefore, points, possible points of maxima minima are x0, y0, x9, y0, x1, y0. Is that thing clear? So you see what we got. This is your boundary. So you get one point inside, 1, 1. And here you get 0, 0. 90 and 110. So these are the possible points of maxima minima. And then on the line, you can take AB or OB, whatever you want. Let us take OB. Along OB, you have x is equal to 0. So boundary, obviously, you have to include. So at x is equal to 0, your function becomes 0, y. That will be 2 plus 2y minus y square. So you will see dy by dy of f0y, that is dy by dy of 2 plus 2y minus y square equal to 0. So that is 2 minus 2y 0, so you'll get y is equal to 1. So y 1, x 0. So you get this point here, y 1, x 0. Okay, and apart from this point and this point, anyway, you have to take. Why? Because you have to find out the maximum minima on the interval 0, 9. So x, y 0, y 9. So this point and this point, you have to take. Is that thing clear, beta? If anybody having doubt till here, please ask.
Ma'am, last me ek bar ye proportion versus suna dena ma'am.
See, along OB, your x is 0. Therefore, your function becomes, you put x is equal to 0, the function becomes a function of y only. So, you have to find the minimum maxima of this function on the interval 0 to 9. So, for that, you will for sure include the boundary points, that is y is equal to 0 and y is equal to 9. That is this point and this point you will include. Let me write down if you want. So, y is equal to 0, y is equal to 9, we have to include. And when you put derivative equal to 0, from there you get y is equal to 1. So, the point which you will get is x 0, y 0, x 0, y 9, and x 0, y 1. Okay? Got it?
Can now, you scroll up?
Yeah. Sure. Any doubt, beta?
Ma'am, in the critical point, when we put it in the function.
Yes.
Ma'am, we got 4, so what are we going to do with this?
Because you see, later on we will see, na? Because the question is find this, we are just saying that this is possible local minima maxima. We don't know as of now, right? Later on, what we will do, we will see that everywhere this is the point, this is the value, this is the value at this point, this is the value at this point. Then out of all those values, we will find out the maximum. That will be your absolute maxima minima. Got it? Okay, yes. Let me complete the understanding, right? Yeah, here also we have to compute the value. Here the value of the function is, if you put, this is your function, 2 plus 2x plus 2y minus x square minus y square. So if you put 0, 0, you will get 2 here. If you put 9, 0, you can compute, this is the value, you will get minus 61. And if you put 1, 0, you will get 3. Okay, so these are the values of the function. And here again, 0, 0, the value is 2, 0, 1. What is the value? 0, 1, the value is 3. And 0, 9, the value is minus 61. Right? Now, still we are left with this boundary AB. So, along AB, so you have y is equal to 9 minus x. Right? So, along AB, this is your AB, 9, 0, 0, 9. Right? So, you have y is equal to 9 minus x. Therefore, your function becomes 2 plus 2x plus 2 into 9 minus x square minus 9 minus x square. So, you just solve it. You'll get minus 61 plus 18x minus 2x square. So, your derivative, this is a function of x only. In place of y, you put 9 minus x. So, your derivative will be the derivative with respect to x. That is dy by dx of minus 61 plus 18x minus 2x square equal to 0. That gives you x 18 minus 4x is equal to 0. That gives you x is equal to 9 by 2. And then you put y is equal to 9 minus x. So that is also 9 by 2. Therefore, critical point is 9 by 2. Sorry, boundary point where minima maxima can occur is 9 by 2, 9 by 2. Right? So this point is somewhere here. 9 by 2, 9 by 2. And apart from this, these boundary points you have already considered when you consider this and this. So boundary you have already considered. So here if you compute the value of the function, it is minus 41 by 2, right? So now you have computed all the critical points. Now let us look at the values. You have this value minus 41 by 2, 3, minus 61, 2, 3, minus 61, 2, and 4. Tell me, which one is the maximum value? So let me write down the values.
Ma'am, the maximum value is 4 and the minimum value is minus 61.
Yeah. So you get 4, 2, minus 61, 3, minus 41 by 2. These are the values. So this is the maximum. This is absolute maximum. And this is absolute minima. right? So this absolute maxima occurs at 1, 1, and this absolute minima occurs at what point? This is at 0, 9 as well as on 9, 0. At 0, 9 and at 9, 0. Okay, so what is happening here is, for this function in this region, these are the possible points of minima and maxima, right? Here is 1, 1. Here is 9/2, 9/2. Here is 9, 0. Here is 0, 9. Here is 0, 0. And then you have 1, 0 and 0, 1. Right? So everywhere we computed the value, we find out that this is the maxima, point of maxima, and these two are the points of minima. This one here and this one here. These are the points of minima. These are the points of minima. This is the point of maxima. Global. Is that okay, beta? Did you get it?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll do one more problem so that you understand. And the similar problems are there in your tutorial sheet also.
Ma'am,
can you please explain this question again?
But let me do the similar problem, one more problem, okay? Similar problem. We still have time. Okay, yeah, we have 12 minutes. I'll do a similar problem so that you understand. And I think in the next class also we can do one or two problems. Can I note it better?
Mummy, kaun si exercise kar rahe hum log?
We are doing, just a minute, I'll tell you. That's 12.8.
12.8, okay, ma'am.
But I have already sent you the questions. 12.1, 12.2. 12.1, you don't have to do much problems from the book. 12.2, 12.3, 12.5, 12.7, and 12.8. These are the exercises which are in our syllabus, okay? So we are like finishing this chapter. Maybe in the next class, we'll start with the new chapter. Okay, beta?
Ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, scroll down. Yeah.
Okay, let me tell you. You should be doing tutorial sheet. Which tutorial sheet you are doing in the class? Yes, beta.
I'm tutorial 5.
Tutorial 5 has completed.
5 you are doing. Okay.
Six. Yeah.
We have finished it.
Yeah, tutorial 5 is about. Yeah, that should be finished. And tutorial 6 also we are doing. That is for chain rule and directional derivative, okay, and maxima minima. No, sorry, maxima minima is in tutorial 7. So you should be doing this. These questions which I am doing is in tutorial 7. So you will be finished till tutorial 7. Okay, beta. So with this chapter, tutorial 7 up to tutorial 7. Fine, beta.
MST ka syllabus kya hoga?
MST, beta, still we don't know, but I think not this chapter completely, but I'm not sure. Let us wait. What?
Ma'am, second, ma'am, ek cheez aur kar dijiye bas, ma'am, ki jaise MST, jaise ma'am MST mein like quizzes hongi, to like ma'am usme har quiz mein pura wo hoga ki matlab distributed rahega.
Beta, we are thinking that we will split.
Okay, ma'am.
So we are planning that we will split the syllabus for MST quizzes, but we are not sure. Okay. I will inform you once I get the information. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
So let us do a similar problem beta quickly. So you have this function fxy is equal to x square plus xy plus y square minus 6x. And you are given that find its absolute maxima minima on the rectangular plate, which is 0 less than equal to x less than equal to 5 minus 3 less than is equal to y less than is equal to 3. Fine. So you see, you are given this function here and you are given this 0 less than x is 0 here. This is a line x is equal to 0. Okay. And then x is equal to 5 is this line. And then y is equal to minus 3 is this line. And y is equal to plus 3 is this line. So this is the region where you have to find out your maximum minima. So again, you will say that we are looking for critical points first. So what are the critical points where fx is 0 and fy is 0 or does not exist? There is no point where fx or fy does not exist because a function is polynomial. So fx 0 gives you 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. And fy is equal to 0 gives you x plus 2y is equal to 0. So you solve these two equations. Solve, you will get x is equal to 4 and y is equal to minus 1. Okay? So 4 comma minus, sorry, y is equal to minus 2. Okay? X is 4, y is minus 2. Yeah. So now can you see where is this point? X 4, y minus 2. Somewhere here. Okay? So this point you have to make sure 4 comma minus 2, this point is inside the region. Otherwise, there is no way. If this point is outside the region, we will not consider that point because we are looking for maximum minima only in the region. And at this point, the value of the function is 4 square minus 8 plus 4 minus 24. So this is the value of this, the function at this point is minus 12. Got it? Now you look for the boundary. Boundaries A, B, C, D. So along AB, so for sure you have to consider this point and this point. What is the name of this point? 0, comma minus 3. 0, comma minus 3 you will consider. And what is the name of this point? 5, comma minus 3. 5, comma minus 3 you will consider. Okay. So if you just take the boundary as such, these corner points you have to consider because we are looking for the maximum minima along AB, then we have to consider A and B. And when you look for B along BC, then you have to consider B and C. Along CD, you have to consider C and D. If you want to just straight away want to take these points, you can take, but it is good to consider like stepwise. So along AB, your Y is minus 3. So along AB, Y is minus 3. You put it in your function. Your function becomes xy will be x square minus 3x plus minus 3 square minus 6x. So this is equal to x square minus 9x plus 9. So this is your function. Is that okay? Is that thing clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now you will just find out the maximum minima. So you'll put derivative with respect to x is equal to 0. That gives you 2x minus 9 is equal to 0. That gives you x is equal to 9 by 2. Calculation is okay?
Yes, ma'am.
The last point is minus 6x. Yeah, we are putting y is equal to minus 3.
Ma'am. dt by dx kya?
Because beta you put y is constant along AB, y is constant, right? So you'll just put derivative with respect to x. Along AB, your function will become a function of x only.
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
So you got the point x is equal to 9 by 2 and y is minus 3. So your point is 9 by 2 minus 3. Okay. So these are the three points you got along AB. So it is somewhere here. 9 by 2 is
9 by 2 is,
ma'am, doubt which one is having the maximum value and which one is having the minimum value. I don't have time to do the calculations because only 3 minutes are left. Okay, beta. So you can complete this problem and in the next class, I will tell you the solution.
Class is till 12:10.
Class is up till 12:10.
Okay, fine. We started the class at 11:20. It will end at 12. Fine, then we can complete it. Okay,
ma'am.
Okay. So So then you can complete this problem, beta. If you want to ask your doubts, then please complete it. And in the next class, I will also tell you the solution. But I want everybody to complete this. Yeah, beta. Now you can ask your doubts.
Yes. Mammy,
हमको series दी है.
Yes.
तो सबसे पहले हम उसका nth term करेंगे.
Which one?
कोई भी अगर series है. या उसकी GP check करेंगे.
What you will check? Partial sum?
नहीं, partial sum और geometric series check करेंगे पहले या nth term पहले करेंगे?
There is no rule. It is your choice.
Okay, ma'am.
It is not compulsory that first we have to check for partial sums or for geometric series or for nth term. No. But I gave you a summary that this is how we generally proceed. Because nth term, if simply you, by looking at the series, you can see that its term, nth term is going to zero. So you can see ki nth term test will not work. That will not tell you anything. So that is why you can skip that part. So that is an idea, but there is no compulsion that this is what you have to follow. Okay, beta?
Ma'am, ek LCT mein doubt tha, ma'am. मैम एलसीटी में जो एन बाई बी एन का जो लिमिट एन अप्रोचेस टू इनफिनिटी है मैम अगर उसका रिजल्ट हमारा इनफिनिटी आ जाता है और उसमें जो समेशन जो बी एन जो हमारा जो ना नीचे वाला सीरीज है अगर वो भी हमारा मैम वो हमारा ना डाइवर्जेंट होता है अगर तब हम ए एन को ना डाइवर्जेंट फिटर कर देते हैं लेकिन अगर बी एन मैम नीचे वाला कन्वर्जेंट आ गया
देन यू विल नॉट सी
इट हम कहां पे
ओके दिस इज इनफिनिटी एंड सिग्मा बी एन इज कन्वर्जेंट
यस मैम
देन यू कैन नॉट सी एनीथिंग अबाउट You can't say anything about.
Ma'am, but मेरा ये question कि जो infinity है वो तो मैम ना c greater than zero वाले case में भी तो आएगा ना.
Sorry.
Ma'am, इसका जो एक जो हमारा पहले.
No, if you look at the logic is that if bn is an upon bn is going to infinity, it means that an is more than bn. Rough logic, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
an ma'am. Is more than bn roughly. Okay, now if its sum is infinity, then its sum will also be infinity,
right? I am asking
that ki jo iski jo pehle wali condition hai usme limit n approaches to infinity an by bn usme agar hamara koi constant value aata hai jo ki greater than 0 hai to wo wali category mein hum isko nahi dal sakte kyunki
finite and not non zero. Okay, infinite. You cannot consider it in that case. C. Okay, this is the condition on C that C should be finite and non-zero.
Achha, theek hai.
Okay, so there is this condition of finiteness also.
Ma'am, to aise questions ko fir solve hi nahi ho payega fir ye to.
No, then you have to
dusra PN dhoondenge.
I have already done the example, beta. You change your BN. It means that this particular BN is not working.
Okay, ma'am. Theek hai, ma'am. And ma'am, एक और क्वेश्चन था मैम ये मैम ये जो लिमिट n अप्रोचेस टू इनफिनिटी ना 1 माइनस 1 बाय 3 n टू द होल पावर n मैम इसको सॉल्व कैसे करेंगे मैम
अगेन टेल मी 1 अपॉन टेल मी बेटा 1 अपॉन एम आई ऑडिबल कैन यू प्लीज रिपीट योर क्वेश्चन ओके एनीबॉडी एल्स हैविंग एनी डाउट
मैम ये
टेल मी 1 माइनस I'm asking number 1 minus.
Beta, you are not audible. 1 minus?
1 by 3.
Yes.
Ma'am, 1 minus 1 by 3 n.
Oh, like this?
Whole to the power
yes,
n.
Ma'am, whole to the power n.
Limit n going to infinity. You tell me how you will find out this. Anybody? No, this is you want to find out the limit. No, you want to find out the limit or you want to find out the.
Ma'am, इसमें हम लोग e to the power, ma'am, इसमें हम लोग e to the power करके नहीं कर सकते, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, yes,
yeah.
ma'am, 1 to the power infinity का form बन जाएगा.
Yes, so for that what
ma'am, you need. उससे तो हो रहा है, ma'am. लेकिन अगर इसमें root test लगाएंगे तब.
No, beta, root test is if
root test के लिए 1 आ जाएगा. 1 के लिए valid नहीं होता.
No, what you are saying, beta, see. There are two different things. One is finding the limit and one is testing the series for convergence or divergence. Right?
Ma'am, I just want to test, ma'am.
You want to test the convergence or divergence? And for that, what yes, you will do if you are going for root test an raised to power 1 by n limit n going to infinity. So what is that? That is yes, 1 ma'am. Minus 3n raised to power 1. limit n going to infinity. That is 1. Therefore, root test fails. Okay? So here, if you simply find the limit of this quantity here, limit n going to infinity, 1 minus 1 by 3 n raised to power n. What is this, students? What is this limit?
E minus
e to the power
e to the minus 3, non-zero. Therefore, divergent by negative term.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Got it? Yeah, any other thing?
No, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay.